Times Influence.
The Brand Vision Summit 2017-2018 saw bigwigs from India Inc. deliberating on building better brands for the future. To gauge the role of leadership in building a global brand, we speak to Deepak Ohri, the CEO of Libua Hotels and Resorts.
Well, I'm now in conversation with Deepak Ohri of Libua Group now, and we're going to be talking about leadership in creating a global brand. Leadership, of course, is tough. Leadership when creating a brand is tougher, and leadership when creating a global brand is even much more tougher than that. So Deepak, let's start off. Creating a global brand. You know, it's easy to say, okay, I'm creating a brand that's in, for example, one country, India. But with Libua, you've crossed the seas. You're prevalent in Thailand, India, other countries. How has it been handling, you know, the cultural differences and other differences that come when you're working across countries?
So there's one thing I learned when I was young. Mark Twain said, don't let your school come in the way of your education. So the most of these experiences you learn over a period of time. Hmm. For us, yes, if I say the journey was easy, it'll be a lie. Hmm. But journey was very comfortable. And going forward, it's even becoming more comfortable because how we started was not to create a hospitality brand. We wanted to create a brand which can create an experience.
Right.
We happen to be in a hospitality business where we are creating experiences. Mm-hmm. And that's how creating a global brand in such a short span of time became much easier for us.
And it is a short span of time in a way because it's just 14 years. But, you know, having that thinking at that point of time, today it's a very common thing. Everybody says, let's look at experience. And especially in the hospitality tourism industry where everyone is now selling an experience as opposed to selling a holiday. But how did you come up with this thought back then, 14 years ago when you started Libua?
So 14 years back when we started Libua, we actually knew that we cannot compete with bigger hotel brands. Mm, mm. And we cannot be one of them. Mm. And if we cannot be one of them, we have to work in a very disruptive manner. Mm. And the way of disruption for us was to create a food and beverage brand that is even bigger than a hotel brand. Experience, the main part of experience is creating a surprise, element of surprise, element of suspense. You don't know what is going to happen, what your journey is going to be, what kind of table you're going to get, where you're going to sit, who's going to serve you, what kind of food it will be. And if you are able to create an experience out of that by understanding a consumer behavior, The key here is a consumer behavior, I think you have mastered the game.
Okay, interesting. But take me through this journey of 14 years. How was it? What were some of the hurdles that came along? Because let's be honest, to the world, everything looks hunky-dory, shiny, bright, and happy. But only the entrepreneur knows what goes, all the toil and all the hard work and all the toiling that goes in the backstage or behind the scene. So take me through that journey.
I think when we started our first restaurant, no interior designer in the world wanted to design.
Okay.
Because the place or the space was like this, that they said, you know, whatever you will do, the place is never going to work. So we hired the office designer. Then we had a marketing company, which is quite a big company. They also refused to market our product.
Okay.
He says, your pricing is wrong. Your whole idea is wrong. There's no way you can be successful. Well, we found a new company to do that, which was, again, a very small company. Then within that restaurant, we opened a bar, which is called Sky Bar, which was the first standing bar of Thailand.
Okay.
Now, Thai people at that point of time would have never even think in their wildest dream that they have to stand at a bar and drink. Because for them, it was like sitting, like I'm sitting here, having a drink and enjoying a drink. So these were few initial hurdles which we overcame with our understanding of consumer behavior, with certain marketing activities, certain challenges, and most of it, lot of luck.
Okay.
And here we are today.
I want to get now to the restaurants. Let's turn back the clock.
Sure.
Again, when you started your first restaurant, that didn't go too well. Like you were telling me about all the hurdles, issues. But what were some of the lessons that you learned from that? And just going ahead, there must have been other hurdles that you faced. What were some of the lessons that you took back?
That was an Indian restaurant I opened in Singapore. Mm. And that didn't do well. It was a great restaurant, but I think we exceeded people's dream and people's expectation, not only our own dream. Mm. And that was the lesson we learned, is that to respect the customer. Understand what the customer wants. Mm. Do not try to change the customer mind. Mm. Understand the customer, what he wants, and then give it to him. And that's the biggest learning that came from that. And until today, we are following that.
The hospitality, the luxury hospitality industry, in fact, is now booming across the world. There was a time, again, I guess, maybe 15 years ago when you started, 20 years, when it was nascent, it was just developing. Was that a thought in your mind at that point of time, saying, I'm getting into something which is not such a big, we're not a big phase at the moment. And let's fast forward to now, 2018, when it is such a booming industry. How has your thought process changed, and how has the industry changed? What are your insights on the industry?
Industry has changed a lot. People's spending habits have changed a lot. People's moods have changed a lot. But I'm going to say something which will surprise all the audience, that luxury is very, very, at its very infancy stage in the world right now.
Okay.
Though there are a lot of brands that they are doing so well, because people understanding of luxury in Asia, if you ask me, is there in Japan, because it got its financial independence after World War II. Mm. And the way of their showing that they got their financial independence is by buying the brands.
Right.
So today, if any Japanese is buying a brand, it is a matter of not showing off, but it is a matter of style, it's a matter of habit.
Hmm.
But elsewhere, luxury is still a question mark. So it's at a very infancy stage.
Okay. In your opinion, what are some of the characteristics that an entrepreneur, a good entrepreneur, should have?
I had no fear of losing.
All right.
That's number one. US today is such a successful country. Mm. It's because it's full of immigrants who had lost everything and had no fear of losing. So once you have no fear of losing, then you are the winner.
Okay, fantastic. Before I let you go, Deepak, one last question. Just any anecdote that you can tell me in your management, in the kitchen, while planning, while managing events, while managing a hotel. Just tell us some funny stories before I let you go.
There was a time when we started a dress code. This is the most funny story, and we start losing 800 customers a day.
Well, okay.
And people thought that, you know what, I've gone mad, and they just started talking that, oh, he must have fallen down and he's lost his mental balance. But not today, it is paying off because the average check and everything has gone high. So I think this is one of the funny stories, but then every story behind the scene is always a funny story. Because till the time there's no funny story behind the scene, there cannot be a simplicity in the front.
Thank you so much for watching. I've been in conversation with Deepak Ohri, the CEO at Libuo, and I have got some great insights, and I sure hope that you've enjoyed the conversation too. Thank you so much for watching.
India's creme de la creme from various industries were being honored at the country's most coveted Next Brands Brand Vision Summit and Awards 2018. The evening witnessed felicitation of icons who are powering India's growth to a global superpower.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Next Brands, I, Danny Jim, your host for the evening, welcomes you all to the Brand Vision Summit 2017-18. May I call upon a very dynamic entrepreneur, Mr. Deepak Ohri, CEO, Lebua Hotels and Resorts. Arjun, thank you very much. Yogesh ji, thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much. Okay, Mr. Ohri, may I request you to stay back, please. I would now like to call upon Mr. Saurabh Bhattacharya, President, Marketing and Sales Nakshatra World to join Mr. Ori. Next, we have a woman of substance. Please put your hands together for none other than Ms. Shilpa Shetty Kundra for her felicitation as the extraordinaire Brand Connect.
Partnered by Times Influence.